Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
वंदे पाप विनाशकम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्।
Thousand universities we had in Madras presidency means now the Tamil Nadu and Andhra and a little bit of Kerala. 200,000 spiritual based education centers. Now we have only 3,000 because the pride on spiritual based education is taken away. The British very clearly they planned and did the first thing. These guys need to lose is the pride in their wealth, in their culture. I was actually surprised because this civilization, this great knowledge is there for last 10,000 years. Nobody was able to shake. How come in last 60 years so much has been lost, especially in Tamil Nadu and South India? Then I realized where The spiritual ideas are taught. That pride is taken away. The utility value of the spiritual ideas are taken away. Then naturally, nobody will study and the pride is not there. It disappears. That was the worst thing happened to the Vedic tradition. Feeling connected to these great ideas, to these great truths, is the first part, faith. Second thing, virya. In Sanskrit, that word virya, it's a very powerful word. Virya, that comes from the root vira. The idea vira is defined not as conquering or killing somebody, but as conquering your own mind and having control over yourself, strength to stand with your mind, strength to stand with your being, strength to maintain the balance in your being, virya, the energy directed in the path, the strength, especially Patanjali here, when he uses the word, he is not saying about killing others, conquering others. No. The Vedic civilization was not built on conquering others. The only country which never invaded any country. Last 5,000 years, 3,000 invasions happened in India. But not even once this guys have gone out and invaded any country. There is a record. In South India, the Chola kings went to Indonesia, the Cambodia, all those places. But they never invaded, killed the local tribes. They created a new civilization. They married. They created a new civilization. In Cambodia, if you see, the amazing temples. The whole thing was carved. In Chennai, we have a place called Mahabalipuram. And it was taken by ship and assembled in Cambodia. People were never killed. The civilization was created, never invaded. So, we are not built on conquering. So, when Patanjali says virya, he means standing with your mind, ability to balance your being. Usually, we have some thoughts, it comes out of your brain and passes through your brain grooves and becomes a vibration in your body and action happens. Only after the action happens, you even know why you had that kind of thought, why you did that kind of action, and you start either repenting or feeling guilty. Virya means having the awareness and strength to catch the thought by the time it comes out. Before even it passes through your brain grooves, before even it affects your decision-making energy, moment it starts, catch it there itself. The virya, ability to catch in the root itself. Ramana Maharshi calls this as aham spurana. Sitting in the space where the aham, the identity is rising. That's what I call virya. We have a beautiful story about this virya. Modern day youth is really suffering. Humanity has never faced this crisis. I have created a 1-year program where you can study the spiritual truths.
Nitya yoga practices to create healthy body. Spiritual discourses to develop mental health. Meditations that help balance emotions. Kriyas to break mental patterns that create suffering. Opportunity to express leadership qualities. Techniques that improve creative skills. Learn to break all self-limiting barriers to achieve your dreams. Ananda Yogam.
I am providing a platform for you to think, meditate, contemplate, and decide about your future. I am giving you 1 year free food, shelter, clothes, above all, the spiritual education and intelligence and intuition to take decision about your future.
Every participant is taught the Vedic truths to live life as it leads in a nurturing ambience, along with inspirational spiritual education that helps bring out the best and achieve one's highest potential.
Youth across the world can come and spend 1 year in Ananda Yogam to work on you, to discover your future, to discover your destiny, or recreate your destiny. I'll open my house for you for 1 year completely free. Come and stay here, discover and recreate your destiny.
Interviews at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
It's a wonderful story. In South India, in a place called Thiruvarur, there is a great saint, Dakshinamurthy Swamigal, an enlightened master, still is. Samadhi is there, his tomb is there, very vibrant, alive, living energy, still is available. Whoever goes to his presence is available. He used to be sitting naked under a banyan tree. He will not wear any cloth, he will sit under the banyan tree and he will be just sitting in a very relaxed, blissful way. Completely fulfilled. That king who was ruling that area had a pride about his courage or his energy to wage war. In Tamil language, there is a tradition, if some king kills 1,000 elephants in the war, 1,000 elephants, a special song will be sung on him with 1,000 verses. It's called Bharani. Called Bharani, that's a kind of a poem, will be sung only to a person who proves his power by killing 1,000 elephants. So this king in the war, in the local wars, he has killed thousands of elephants, and the local court poet sung that song on him with 1,000 verses praising his glory. And these kings have no other work, and these poets also no other work. This guy has to sing and he will give money. And it goes on and on and on. This poet, suddenly he felt, sometime like this, how the scientists feel, they are bending the truth for the person, for the sake of the person who is funding the research and development. So he also had a guilt. I think I am singing about this guy, even though this guy is not worthy of what I am singing. Because he gives money, I am singing. I should stop. The conflict between Lakshmi and Saraswati, the intellect and wealth, started in him. Should I continue to use my Saraswati to get little Lakshmi? Asked, should I stand up and do only what I believe as truth? Suddenly, somehow, he was possessed by Shraddha. Shraddha Vivecha. Shraddha possession happened on him. He was possessed by Shraddha, the strength and straightforwardness. And he starts seeking a guru to achieve inner fulfillment. That's a great thing in the Vedic civilization. The moment you start thinking inside. You want to look further in the life. Either by fear or greed, or depression or pain or suffering or anything, they will start seeking guru. They will not even bother. They will not say, I will commit suicide, I will do that, I will do this, I will become a swami. Because it is in the very air. This guy starts trying to find out a swami. Fortunately, he gets the opportunity to meet this Dakshinamurti Swami. He comes and sits in the presence. Neither that Swami spoke a single word, nor that poet asked any question. Somehow just that click happened. That click happened. When that click happens, see, it's like a loaded gun being triggered. The poet was a loaded gun filled with seeking. The presence of the Swami is just triggering. See, if you trigger the unloaded gun, nothing will happen. If you don't trigger the loaded gun, nothing will happen. Both should meet and match and merge. The seeking and the enlightened person's presence. Here, both merged. And no words are shared. Just Dakshinamurti Swami will show through his body language. Sit, relax. The poet sat quietly. The intense presence of the master, the thoughts per second in poet's mind started reducing drastically. The TPS started coming down. Tuck, 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 tuck. In few seconds, the poet was in deep silence.
क्या आप स्वयं एक अवतार पुरुष से अपने जीवन में दिव्य मार्गदर्शन चाहते हैं? प्रस्तुत करते हैं अवतार पुरुष से वार्ता।
नित्यानंदम, नित्यानंदा हियर।
परमहंस नित्यानंदा संसार को एक और अतुल्य और अनोखी भेंट दे रहे हैं।
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
अब वो लाइव किसी के भी प्रश्नों का उत्तर स्वयं देंगे.
That's great. Now you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
आठ से प्रारंभ. कुछ सौभाग्यशाली लोग जो 0807-272-9999 पर फोन करेंगे, वो स्वयं स्वामी जी से बात कर सकते हैं. लाइव देखें एनटीवी पर ntv.nityananda.org.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nityananda. Nityananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. it can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting, and design offered in the Ingenious program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of all abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings.
He was almost in samadhi. He was in samadhi. Maybe after 2 days, Dakshinamurti Swami, he moved his hand. Then slowly that poet came to awareness, the ordinary consciousness, the ecstasy, the joy, the fulfillment was so much. He sang the same Bharani song, same the 1,000 verse which he sang to the king, in the same meter, he sang about this Swami, saying, killing 1,000 elephants is much easier than killing the mind. You killed my mind, so you are worthy of Bharani. He sings Bharani. He sings about this master in the same meter. He sings for that master. Till then everything was going smooth. Now problem starts. Naturally, always among the poets, there will be somebody who don't like this poet. The competition poet, he went and told the king, don't think you are the only one with the Bharani in this country. King said, who else can have Bharani like me? I am the only one. The poet says, no. The poet who sang Bharani on you The same guy has sung Bharani and another one beggar. This king says, how dare he sing that same meter on some beggar. This poet has to prove that beggar is worthy of that Bharani. Who is here who can kill 1,000 elephants except me? This poet, he did his job, he escaped. That poet who sang the Bharani, he was called. He was called and king asked, how dare you sing in the same meter that Swami also? What do you mean? You have to now prove that he is worthy. He has killed 1,000 elephants. Otherwise, your head will be cut. That's the usual dialogue. Always the kings have to use the dialogue. And the poet says, I don't know about cutting my head and all those things. All I say, if you can, just come once and see him. After that, whatever decision you take, I can't tell anything. It is going to be executed. It is going to happen. So you do what you want. But I have my love for you. Just because of that, I tell you, come and see him once. The Chola king, he goes with all his, the Radha, Gaja, Pada, all the senas, all the army, with his ministers. The whole kingdom goes to that master. The king walks in the front and all these guys are following. And they reach the place where that Swami is sitting. Huge banyan tree, young guy, sitting naked, not bothered at all, just fulfilled. His eyes are open, but he is not seeing anything. Because there is nothing to be seen. He can see everything inside. So his eyes are open, but eyeballs are not moving. He is there in Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Suddenly, the moment king saw him, something clicked. Because whenever king sees people, he sees very clearly the fear which is there in that person and how that civilians obey, how that citizens obey. He sees the respect, he sees the fear. First time he is seeing a man, there is no trace of fear. See, kings are very intelligent. They know how to create fear in people. That is why they are kings. See, they are sitting in the throne because they are able to create fear in everybody. He sees his presence or his whole army is unable to shake him. The guy is in his silence, fulfillment. Suddenly something happens to him. How come? How can a person be without having fear about me and my army? Means there is no fear of death in him. He goes near. Swami is just sitting in his deep silence. Slowly, more and more the king gets closer. Same thing which happened to the poet starts happening in the king. The number of thoughts is reducing. Understand, you will be violent and arrogant only if the TPS is high. If the thoughts per second drops, you can neither be violent nor be arrogant. The ego will disappear, it will melt, die down.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
When the number of thoughts, that restlessness, that irritation, that agitation, when it started coming down, ego started melting, violence started melting, the arrogance started melting, he went and sat like a puppy next to the master. Understand, I am not describing some story, I am describing the event which happened. It's a history. It happened. All that Swami did, he just showed through his eyes, close your eyes and sit, relax. Don't worry, your army is not going to be useful here. Relax. The way in which he looked, the body language he radiated, the courage and confidence which was in his eyes and in his being, just the things. Master says, sit, relax. The king looked too small in front of the presence of this great Swami. The master's presence, the presence of a beggar, the great king looked too small. He just sat. Because king sat, the whole army sat. Because the whole army sat, all the ministers sat. Because all the ministers sat, the whole citizens sat. The whole kingdom is sitting at the feet of this beggar. And the whole kingdom was in that silence. Story says, one day passed, 2 days over, third day, Dakshinamurti Swamigal, he felt little compassionate. All these guys are sitting for 3 days. Without food, maybe they have to go back and have food. He just lifted his face and lifted his hand, told the king, now go back. Suddenly, king came to the normal awareness, filled with ecstasy, joy, and that experience of the deep silence which he never experienced in his life. The arrogance and violence will never let you relax. First time in his life, he experienced himself. That restful awareness, the deep joy, the deep fulfillment, the deep peace and bliss. The king, he was unable to speak. If you sit for half an hour like that intensely, you will see very clearly your tongue will be locked. You can't speak. You can't speak. And he sat for 3 days. He was not able to speak. The tears are pouring. He just did namaskar, came out and looked into that poet and said, the only mistake you did, you shouldn't have sung Bharani on him, you should have sung Dharani. Dharani means the meter which is sung for the people who killed 10,000 elephants. Not thousand. He says, killing 1,000 elephants, the king says, killing 1,000 elephants is easy. All you need is the technique and the muscle and weapon, that's all, nothing else. But killing not only your mind and anybody who comes in front of you, they are everybody's mind, is millions and millions of times greater than any ordinary war or killing. So he says, not just Bharani, Singh Dharani, means he is worthy of the ultimate respect, Singh. And that poet sang Dharani, still the whole thing is there in stone. If you go to his tomb, still you will see the whole thing, the evidence of the whole incident. When Patanjali uses the word virya, he is not giving you the idea of fighting with others, not that virya, not that courage, not that strength. Ability to stand with your mind, ability to stand in your inner space, that is what he calls virya, effort. Again and again and again, trying to come back to the deepest space of your being, that silence. Unclutch and come back to the silence. If your mind runs away, some thoughts come. Again, unclutch and come back to the silence. Every time you unclutch, it is equal to killing one elephant. If you also kill 10,000 times your thoughts, you are worthy of Dharani, you will become Dakshinamurti. You will radiate the same presence, understand? Every time you unclutch from a thought and come back to the silence, you have killed one elephant. So decide, you will kill at least 10,000 elephant, means 10,000 thoughts, not the elephant, 10,000 thoughts. 10,000 thoughts, unclutch and come back to the inner space, you are worthy of Dharani. That is what Patanjali calls here virya. I do not want to add more and more ideas. I want you to internalize, digest these few ideas. These two ideas, faith and effort, internalize these two ideas today. Shraddha and Virya, having feeling connection to the spiritual truths. Virya, the courage to stand. Live those spiritual truths. Internalize these two ideas. You will see you are living enlightenment. Understand?
Just an hour's drive from Bangalore, Asia's fastest growing city, is a unique space of healing, meditation and rejuvenation. Welcome to Nityananda Dhyanapeetam. Experience soothing, healing energies under the ancient wish-fulfilling banyan tree in the presence of divinity. Enjoy the unique anti-aging formula of the original Siddha Healing Spa with the 21-foot energized healing lingam and healing pool, the Vaidya Sarovar. Connect directly to God in the vibrant silence of Nityanandeshwara Temple. Savor the delicious sattvic food served free at all times. Best of all, get a glimpse of authentic spiritual life at the daily morning satsang, worship, yoga and meditation sessions with Paramahamsa Nityananda. Rediscover yourself at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, the ultimate spiritual lifestyle destination. Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore. 562-109. Contact 0974-22-033-11. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.